Saturday we'll go, Sunday we'll go, and Monday we'll come. And there was Mrs. Thompson in front of her class. She entered the class, just went back, just like she did all the other days. She had a habit of saying, "Love you all," before starting any of our classes. But she couldn't feel that love for one student in the class who was untidy, untattered, and always have had a very negative attitude. She couldn't encourage that student to be a good student or be one of the person who would be attentive in the class or participate. That year, Mrs. Thompson, that quarter report was done by her. And when she was making the quarterly report, Teddy's name came up. Teddy was the one who we are talking about. And she thought to herself, "I have nothing positive to write about this kid." She told that a positive report, progress report should report some progress, but I have nothing good to write about this one. So she called the administrative staff and told to bring all the previous reports of Teddy to her. And Mrs. Thompson looked at the third standard report and said, "Teddy is the most brilliant student in the class." She was stunned. She went to the fourth standard report, and progressively all standard reports suggested that Teddy's mother was suffering from terminal cancer. And that was beginning to show up on Teddy's performance. The sixth year standard report stated, "Teddy has lost his mother, and along with that, himself. He desperately needs help, otherwise we shall lose him too." By then, there were tears in Mrs. Thompson's eyes. She looked at the administrative staff and said, "I know what to do now." And she went back to class. Probably it was a Monday morning. She stood on the stage and she again said, "Love you all." But she knew she was lying, because the love she felt for Teddy was far, far beyond anybody present in the class. And she made up her mind that for every positive reason, Teddy's name will be called. She encouraged Teddy for all reasons, and that began to show up on Teddy's performance. At the end of that year, Teddy became one of the best students in the class. At the end of that year, all students got some gifts for Mrs. Thompson, their teacher. And among those, there was a newspaper wrapped gift which was lying in the middle. Mrs. Thompson saw it, and she immediately knew that must be from Teddy. She quickly unwrapped it, and there was a half-used perfume bottle and a bracelet from which few petals had already fallen out. The whole class started laughing, but Mrs. Thompson wore the bracelet, and she put the perfume over to her body and went towards Teddy. It seemed Teddy quietly, with a quarter smile, and said, "You smell like my mother. This is the same perfume which she last used when she left. And this is the thing which was taken out of her body when she was taken to the coffin." A year later, she received a note written, "I've seen few more teachers in life, but Mrs. Thompson, you're still the best teacher I've ever seen. Love, Teddy." Each and every year, Mrs. Thompson received that same letter from Teddy. And till the time Teddy passed out, she kept on getting that letter. Years rolled by, they lost out of contact. She also retired from the school. One day, an agent somehow traced Mrs. Thompson and gave a letter to Mrs. Thompson, stated, "Dr. Theodore, PhD. Teddy had gone on to become a PhD. And the letter stated, "I've seen few more people in life, but Mrs. Thompson, you're still the best teacher I've ever seen. I'm getting married, and I can't imagine getting married without your presence and without a blessing. Love, Teddy." And along with that were enclosed to and fro tickets to that destination where Teddy was getting married. She was excited. She couldn't resist. She didn't have the perfume bottle there, but she still had the bracelet. And on the day of the marriage, she rushed to the church and she was trying to accommodate herself some back in the back rows, but the volunteers recognized her. And she was ushered to right the first row. And right in the first row, there was a seat with a placard beneath her. Teddy personally requested Mrs. Compton to sit there. And he whispered, "You're the closest I've ever imagined and got to being her." He introduced himself, her, Mrs. Thompson, to his would-be wedded wife and said, "Whatever I am today, I am because of her. Whatever I've achieved up till now, I owe each and everything to her." Well, when I read this story, the same words echoed within me. Whatever I am today, I am because of my mother. And what I stand here, I am living for whatever I've gone through, from that I've achieved, and I am still standing here. It's all because of my mother's support. I owe everything to her. It's a request to all of you today that when you go back home, try to be the Teddy in there, like Teddy in your life, and give that same amount of love and compassion to your mother. Back to you, Master Simon.